Welcome back, everybody. I'm Dr. Jason Hooper, doctor of physical therapy and orthopedic clinical specialist, and today we're going to be talking about trigger finger.
Is that someone else's hand in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me?
Oh, hey there. So trigger finger is actually referred to as stenosing flexor tenosynovitis, but because I don't want to say that every time, we're going to refer to its layman's term of trigger finger. So simply put, trigger finger is a disparity in the size of the flexor tendon and the A1 pulley that covers it. So the flexor tendons will pass through these pulley systems, and if the flexor tendon becomes like inflamed, so it gets a little bit enlarged, it will have more difficulty passing through it. Now the flexor tendons pass through those pulleys as you flex and extend your finger. So this tendon will actually slide down and back through, and that's where you'll get that catch. If you have like this narrow part and then maybe you have inflammation through here of that flexor tendon, as it's going through, it's gonna get caught on that wider section, and then it'll slide through after if you apply enough force. It'll be a painless catch, snap, or lock as you flex your finger, progressing to a painful catch, and then eventually to difficulty and or pain extending the finger. You may also have pain right at this MCP joint, or right kind of at the knuckle on the palmar side of your hand as this symptom progresses. You may feel a nodule or kind of an enlargement in this area, but that's kind of hard to tell on your own, but you can try and compare it side to side or between the other fingers as well. So the cause of this is generally more overuse related. Medical literature doesn't attribute trigger finger to just one specific thing that they can pinpoint, but we wanna look at those overuse issues, or if we're getting a lot of MCP flexion with an activity or a job, we wanna be careful with that, or if you're creating a lot of pressure on that MCP joint or that knuckle all the time with your work. Those are things to be mindful of. Now, if your symptoms are more acute, that's when you'll get that more painless snapping or catching, or if these symptoms are more chronic, that's gonna be more painful. That's a more serious condition that may need more aggressive intervention, which we'll talk about later in the treatment section. Okay, so as you would imagine, testing for this was gonna be quite simple. You're just gonna go in the palm up position, and you're gonna bend and extend that affected joint. Now you wanna try different positions or different angles with it and see if you can replicate that catch. Not every time it will have a catch with it. That doesn't mean you don't have trigger finger, but if you can reproduce it with that simple test, then you may be looking at a trigger finger issue. Treatment for trigger finger is gonna involve activity modification, so paying attention to what you're doing with your climbing, your grip position, and then especially your work-related activities. But one of the more important things we're gonna look at is gonna be splinting. So if you have this acute inflammation and you're developing trigger finger, there's two different kinds of splints that you can get. This is actually a custom splint that was made for me that will block flexion of your MCP joint, so this guy here, but will still allow me to bend at my PIP and my DIP. So that will allow me a little more function in my like regular activities. Now you can also get what's called an oval 8 splint. So these are not custom made. You can get them online, and they like are sized to different fingers, but what this one will do is it'll block both the MCP flexion as well as the PIP flexion. So really I only get flexion at that DIP joint. The purpose of both of these splints is to reduce the traveling of those flexor tendons through the A1 pulley to try and decrease that irritation or inflammation so you're not gonna develop that chronic trigger finger. So a custom splint is usually gonna be made by a hand therapist. So if you get a referral, you get to go see one of them, they can usually make this splint for you, and it'll usually be taped into position to hold it there. It won't just be sitting on my hand like these guys are. The oval 8 stays in position pretty well, but that most likely will have some tape as well, just to help hold it in position so it doesn't slide on and off throughout your regular routine. So another thing that you can do for treatment with this is an A1 pulley stretch. So research has shown that this is effective, and you can do it when you don't have acute symptoms. So you need anything basically that you can put in your palm that will create this positioning. So essentially what it's going to be doing is we're pulling in while pushing through the palm. And as you can imagine, because of those flexor tendons, that position, it wants to essentially pull down through this MCP joint. So by pulling in through here and holding that contraction, we're gonna get a stretch to that A1 pulley. Now, if you couple that stretch with your activity modification to reduce the swelling or irritation to the flexor tendon, you're getting both a reduction in that size of the flexor tendon while also improving the space for it to go through at that A1 pulley. So if you've tried those forms of treatment out and you're not having a lot of success, some other things that you might need to do, you may have some success with trying to like mobilize the soft tissue in that area, or you may need to see like your physician who may prescribe like a trial of non-steroidal anti-inflammatories. Eventually they may do an injection to the tissue, or the end, which we would really want to avoid as a climber, they would have to do a little bit of a surgery. If this is a chronic issue and you're like having really a lot of pain and difficulty flexing and extending your finger, the surgery like works really well, but keep in mind as a climber, a lot of the pressure then is gonna go to your A2 pulley, which we already create a lot of pressure with crimping. So you just wanna be aware of that if you're still trying to climb really hard and aggressively. All right, one last note. So you may think if you have this and you still wanna climb or train that like doing some pull-ups or jug hauls will be helpful. Well, actually, if you're putting a lot of pressure on that MCP joint and you're like fully flexed at that MCP joint as well, that may actually irritate those issues, not make them better. So doing climbing where you're more in that like straight or open hand position is probably gonna be better. If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe, and until next time, train, climb, send, and repeat. Dude, I woke up at like 5 this morning. Stupid. As I was like doing the work, I was like, I shouldn't have woken up. This is pointless. I'm too stupid right now. Ooh. What am I doing? I need to get my hand locked.
So casual.
What's up, guys? Hey, everyone.
You should be like out of frame.
Howdy. Wait, yeah. Get out of here, coffee. We're like ready, huh? You like want me to start doing things, huh?
I'm ready.
Welcome back, everybody. And now I have to say my name. So trigger finger is actually called stenosing flexor. I messed it up.
I couldn't tell.
So you want to look at those different lifestyle modifications. I don't want to go into that treatment. How did I do it? Oh yeah, acute and chronic. They don't have one specific cause that they can relate this to or attribute the, that's what I want to say, attribute it to. Because we're going on to activity modification and then we're done. I'm going to just have the splints on. I'm going to have it like covered up like this and I'm going to be like, boom.
Oh, the reveal.
They want you to be like so comfortable with yourself that they make it skin tone.
Because otherwise you'd be so disturbed.
So disturbed with this thing, which is not a custom, dang it.
How do you get a custom made one?
You had to be a baller. He's actually shown this in the research that, okay. So another thing that's been proven to help with research, no. So if you don't have acute symptoms and you, I forgot the research part. This is what happens. I just get lost for a while. Quiet you. Shh. Your flip-flops are too loud. Thank you. Okay, we good?
We're good.
We're great. So if you've tried those forms of treatment. Cool. All right, we're done. I'll be in my trailer.
Oh. Oh, hey, you're still here. Jason, they're still watching.
Oh. Heyo.
Dude, say something cool so they like the videos and subscribe for more awesome content.
Like and subscribe for more super sweet vids, y'all.
So lame, dude. So lame.
I thought it was pretty good.